I'm a lecturer in women's studies at MIT. When Rohit Vemula wrote to P. Appa Rao, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Hyderabad, asking him, quote, to please serve 10 milligrams of sodium azide to all the Dalit students at the time of admission, supply a nice robe to the rooms of all Dalit students, he was well aware of the history of atrocities against Dalit students at the institutions of higher learning in India. Death of Merit, a Dalit student's portal, lists 19 suicides across India between January 2007 and 2011, and this is a partial list. M. Shrikant, Ajay Chandra, Jaspreet Singh, Senthil Kumar, Shant Kuril, G. Suman, Ankita Vaite, D. Shyam Kumar, S. Amravati, Bandi Anusha, Pushpanjali Purti, Sushil Kumar Chaudhary, Balmukund Bharti, J. K. Ramesh, Madhuri Sale, V. Varalakshmi, Manish Kumar, Dinesh Mohan Gavle were young people in the prime of their lives, studying in India's premier institutions, the IITs, the IIMS, IISc, to name a few. And some of them came from rural families, where they were the first ever to step inside an educational institution. Little did they know what awaited them. Little did they know how deep caste prejudice runs in these places, how vicious would be the behavior of some of their fellow students, professors, and administrators, and how tormented and isolated they would be made to feel inside these portals of higher learning. Rohit Vemula's death speaks to the everyday violence meted out to Dalit students and faculty alike. In these ways, we can all be implicated in Rohit's death, as we witness these indignities and atrocities and turn a blind eye. We have remained silent not only in the universities, but also in our homes and neighborhoods, where issues of purity and pollution remain as entrenched as ever, and oppression continues to wield its ugly head. However, on a different register, Rohit's death reminds us of the chilling political climate of today, where Dalit students in particular can be labeled anti-nationalists, extremists, and even casteists for screening a film, for being part of an organization. And this is what I want to turn our attention to. I think it is true that there are atrocities, everyday atrocities, that we all have become, you know, kind of insulated from. But in today's climate, what we've been witnessing is to turn the table to accuse Dalit students of being anti-national, of being casteist, by people in power who have taken to, you know, sort of really vilifying the atmosphere. You cannot screen a film, for heaven's sakes, in a university. What kind of political freedom is this? India boasts of being the biggest democracy. And time and time again, it's, you know, Rohit Vemula's is one case. We have Sandeep Pandey being, you know, dismissed summarily by, you know, the BHU chancellor for allegedly showing a film, which he says he didn't show in anything. Even if he'd shown the film, that is no reason, right? So we have to really understand the really chilling climate where there is no political dissent allowed, especially when that dissent comes from Dalit communities, from the most marginalized communities. And it is this that, in fact, troubles us the most in all of it, because we've seen these. This is a regular, you know, if you, I only gave you, you know, whatever I could find on this portal, but if you just looked in the last 5 years, there are many, many, many cases of students at the premier institutions of India where they have come on their own merit. There's a student from AIMS, called India Institute of Medical Sciences, who was 12th in the, you know, in the selection list, but was given a reservation quota and was treated so poorly that he took his life. I mean, there are countless cases like that. And I think we have to understand both these aspects together. One, things that we ourselves do not raise enough voice about, and the other is the ways in which the current government is just really stifling all opposition, and in particular the opposition that comes from the institutions, and the fact that he belonged to Ambedkar's society, Students' Association, was a very big step. And there is a kind of terror that is being, you know, perpetuated in India right now. And it comes in not only for Dalit students, it's also about women's, you know, sexuality and, you know, control of that. I was in Bombay just recently, and you cannot get a room in Bombay today if you want to, if there are two young people, or not so young for that matter, who want to get a room in Bombay, you cannot get it today unless you can show them your marriage certificate. I mean, this kind of, you know, sort of deep surveillance that is going on. I'm really glad to hear that Rohit was admirer of Assange for that matter. But this kind of surveillance that we are witnessing in India is really quite chilling and very, very scary. And I think it's time that we raised our voice. We are parts of very, you know, powerful universities, and at least the rhetoric is that we should support freedom of expression. And if we can't even stand up for that, given what was meted out to Rohit Vemmula, I think that we are not doing our job.